Hello student, welcome to my channel. This is Vasant Naik from Canada Engineering College. Today we will continue K-map session. In the last previous video, you have seen what is K-map. So let me repeat. K-map is nothing but a visual or a pictorial representation of fundamental products or fundamental sum for a POS or SOP solution. That is, you want to solve SOP or POS expression, then it is a pictorial representation of fundamental products or fundamental sums. In K-map, you have like two variable K-map, four variable K-map, and in K-map, you have two variable K-map, four variable K-map, and three variable K-map. So, in K-map representation also, we have seen the previous video. So, today we will see some of the problems and how to solve all those problems. Now, let's consider this problem. K-map representation is given and you have to group it and you have to solve it. So, let's consider this problem. Here, K-map representation is given and you have to solve it. You have to see how many groups are possible. So, for that, let me take you to Blackboard. So, let me use this one. Now, I will draw the same K-map what I shown just now. So, let me draw here. The first M0 was 0 and this was 0. Yeah, first one is M0 is 0, M1 is 1, M2 is 1, M2 is 0, M3 is 1, M4 is 0, M5, minterm 5 is 0, minterm 6 is 1 and minterm 7 is 1. So now, how you can do the grouping here? Now the question is, how you can do the grouping here? Now, can you do the four ones? Or quarter grouping here? No, that is not possible because all these ones are not ascent properly. So here you can see you can make the grouping of two ones. You can make the grouping of two ones, and here you can make the group of two more ones. So one grouping is this one. This is the one grouping. Second one is this one. Now, one more question comes. You can make a group of this one also. You can make a group of this one. But this group is called as non-essential group. These groups are called as essential prime implicants. The grouping solution is called as prime implicants. So, we have one prime implicant, you will get one prime implicant after solving this group, you will get one more prime implicant after solving this group, but third group is not essential. Why? This one is covered by this group, this one is covered by this group. So, this is not essential group, this is not essential group. So, we have to consider only two groups. So, first while writing, you have to write the answer for all the groups. Let me call this group is G1. Let me call this is group 1. And this group I will call group 2. And this group I will call group 3. Now let me write the answer for the group 1. To write the answer for the group 1, you have two cells here. Two cells. And horizontally you have only one variable that you have to write. And vertically you can see here. B is common. B is common. C is not common. Here in this vertical, this column C, and in the other column it is C bar. C is not common. B is common. So, answer is AB for this group. Now, what is the answer for this group? First, see horizontally. Horizontally, only one variable is there. So, answer for this group is A bar. And vertically, top side, what is the changes? You see, here and here. In this group, this column and this column, you see. What are the common terms? Common term is C. B is not common because B and B bar is there. C is common. So, I will write the answer is equal to C. And in the third group, vertically there is no common because A bar is there, A is there, no common. Horizontally only one column is there and you have to write that one. Answer is BC. Now, as I said, this expression is not, this group is not essential. So, while writing SOP, I have to write function of A, B and C, function of A, B, C is equal to function of A, B, C. Answer for this one, function of A, B, C is nothing but we have group 1, that is A, B, and we have group 3, A bar C, group 3. This is the answer. This is called as minimal SOP expression. This is called as minimal SOP expression. This is minimal SOP expression. Now, if you can ask the question saying that if you include this one, what will happen? Let us see now, if you include this one, BC, what will happen? So, what we do is we will include BC also. So, let me include BC so when you solve this one by using our distributive laws or Boolean theorems and laws, then you will get the final answer is equal to, here also you will get the final answer AB and A bar C. That means this term will get vanished. That's why when you use K-map, try to see which are the essential prime implicants, which are the non-essential. In this case, this is non-essential. So, don't write that one. Only essential you write. And one more thing is, you should not solve it once again by using Boolean laws and theorems. If you solve this, if you solve the expression by using Boolean laws and theorem, then the whole idea of K-map will be lost. That's why you have to solve by using K-map only. So, this is the one problem we saw. So, one more problem we will see here. So, in this problem you can see, one group is this one and one more group is this one. So, first group answer you have to write. First group. So, this is group 1, answer is A bar C, we have already seen. Second group answer is BC and our final expression is, suppose if it is a function Y, then it is A bar C plus BC. This is the way of solving. This is called as minimal SOP. Now, third one is, you see here, four ones are there. When you see four ones, you can group four ones, four adjacent ones you can group. You can group four adjacent ones. Now, what is the answer? When you group four ones, vertically only one variable is there. Horizontally, all the variables will get negated. For example, C bar will get negated with C, this C will get negated with this C bar, B bar will get negated with B, and this B bar will get negated with B. That means only answer is A. So, when you group three variables, you will get the answer in terms of two variables. When you group four variables, like four ones, you will get the answer like C single variable. So you can see here one more group. So like this also grouping is possible, and the answer for this group is horizontally, vertically all the variable get negated, and horizontally at the top side the answer for this column is CD. Similarly, you can see other grouping also. Suppose if it is like this, you can group because it is all the ascent ones. And now when you write the answer, then you have to vertically you have to consider these two cell, these two rows. So which is the common here and here common is B. That is B. And top side you have to consider this and this and this column. Then which is the common here? D. The answer is BD. Answer is BD. So you can group cells something like this. All these are called adjacent cells. So when you group this cell, you have to remember one thing. Here some students will group like this. They will make a separate group of two ones. But we have a provision to make a group of four ones because these and these cells are adjacent. So when these cells are adjacent, you can make a group of four ones. And what is the answer? So answer is first you have to see vertically which is common A, and then you have to see top side horizontally which column you have to see, this column and this column. In this column and this column which is the common? D bar. So answer is AD bar. Answer is AD bar. Like this different types of grouping you can see here. Why I am solving these examples is like you will come to know how you can make different groups. Like here you can see the grouping difference, here you can see different grouping, here you can see here and here. Different type of groupings are possible. When you group, you have to see first can you make a group of 8 ones or 4 ones, then you go for a group of 2 ones. So students, here this in this this one K map you can see like how you can group eight ones. Suppose eight ones are like this, then you can group 8 ones. Don't go for a grouping of 4 ones because you can make a group of 8 ones. If 8 ones are like this, you can make a group of 8 ones. Or if 8 ones are like this also, these are ascent ones. Don't go for grouping of 4 ones. 8 ones, you can make a group of 8 ones. Or if it is 8 ones are like this, you can make a group of 8 ones. So when you make a group of 8 ones, then for in the first case, you have to see here vertically and horizontally, B is common. Horizontally, all variables will get cancelled. So answer is B. When you make a group like this, you have to see vertically all variables will get cancelled, negated. Horizontally, common is D. So when you group like this, you have to see first row and last row. In first row, last row, vertically, which is common, you see. Vertically is common is in first row and last row. Vertically, there is no common. Both are get. There is a common, that is B bar. But horizontally there is no common, like all these are get negated. So answer is B bar. Like this, this is the different way of grouping 8 ones. We'll see one more example here. Here you can see we have ones in the corner. This is called a corner grouping, ones in the corner. But if you see this one, all these cells are adjacent cells. That's why you can make a group of corner ones like this. You can make a group of corner ones. If only 2 ones are there, you can make a group of 2 ones. If 4 ones are there, you can make a group of 4 ones. In this case, we are making a group of 4 ones. All corner ones you can group. Corner ones or corner zero, depending on SOP or POS. This is corner one you can group. Now, when you grouping, you have to see this row and this row. So, which is common here? B bar. B bar is a common. Then vertically you have to see on top side you have to see this column and this column which is common, D bar. So answer is a BD bar. So this is the one more method of grouping. So now students will see one more problem here. You can see this is the representation of SOP terms in K-map. This is the four variable K-map. So here we can make a tree group. How we can make tree group in this case? We'll try to solve this one. So this is the representation of four variable map. So let me write the min terms what we saw in the last slide. Let me write. So we have 1 year. Year one was there. Year one was there, and year one was there. And other than that, we have 1, 1, and 1. So how you can make a group? First, we can make a group of this one, 4 ones. You can make a group, and you can call this group as first group. I will call this group as G1. And one more group. What are the remaining ones here? These 3 ones. You can't make a group of 3 ones, but 2 ones I can make a group. But while making 2 ones group, I can club it along with this group. This is called as overlapping. This is a overlapping. I can club this one along with this one, and I can make a 4 ones. So let me make separate group here. 4 ones. This is 4 ones. One more group, and I will call this group as G2. And remaining one is this one. For this one, you can make a separate group. Separate group of 4 ones. So you can make a separate group of 4 ones, including these 3 ones. So this is G3. So 3 groups are possible. First group, second group, and third group. So what is the answer for first group? G1. All the variables in the top side will get cancelled, negated. So on the vertical side, we have A bar, B bar. So answer for this one is A bar, B bar, A bar, B bar. And answer for G2, you have to consider this and this. So here common is A bar. So here common is A bar horizontally. Vertically common is A bar. Horizontally common is here common is A, that is not A bar. Here common is A, and here common is horizontal top side common is D is the common. You can see D. This is C bar, this is C, D. So answer is for this one is D. What about G3? G3 also you have to take vertically common. Common is G3. For G3 also vertically. For G3 also vertically common is A. And horizontal common you have to see. Horizontal here and here. So here and here common is C. So what is the final expression? Final expression you have to write. So final expression you have to write. That is F of 4 variables A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D is equal to, we have first group G1, G2 and G3. So G1 is equal to A bar, B bar. G2 is equal to AD. G3 is equal to AC. So these are the 3 groups. So G1, G2, G3. So like this you can solve. This is called as minimal SOP expression.